Plugins for Final Cut Pro are keep getting crazier and crazier and crazier, and I don't know where it's gonna end. In this video, we're gonna take a look at the FCPX camera from Pixel Film Studios, a plugin that allows you to create different effects, very unique effects that can mimic camera effects and camera tools. Let me explain. With this plugin, you get effects like camera movements, viewfinder interfaces, camera ISO and grain, shutter angle tools, camera filters like the halation diffusion tool, focus tools, camera lens tools, shake tools, zoom tools, and this is just a small portion of what you can get. Before we begin on how you can use it inside Final Cut Pro, let me tell you that you will find a link in the description of this video down below where you can get it, and if you use the coupon code EmilioPixel, you will get a discount. I'm not telling you how much. Click it, EmilioPixel, and you will find out. Keep in mind that this is an affiliate link, which means that if you make the purchase from this link, you support this channel. I'm Emilio, welcome to my channel, and let's dive inside Final Cut Pro. As soon as you download and install the effect, you will see that on the titles, you find a lot of different adjustment layers which contain the effects. For example, we can see that first of all, we have basic movement tools, and this is the 3D camera tool, the 3D camera tool framing, and the camera path tool. Let's see exactly what do they do. For this example, I will have a footage of people talking to each other, and I'm gonna go to the basic movement tools and grab the camera path tool. I'm gonna bring it on top, adjust the size. Now I will go into the inspector panel on the right, and remember that in all of these adjustment layer effects, you have all of different parameters and options that you can use in the inspector panel on the right, and you can adjust the settings and have different results. Remember that, because I'm not gonna go into too much details into all of the different effects. For this example, we're gonna set the start and the end point. It is as easy as that. So for the start position, I will go here. I will select the X axis. Let's say I'm gonna start from here. The Z, which controls a little bit of the zoom, and the Y. For the movement speed, I have the option to go with linear, ease in, ease out, ease both. That means that it controls how smooth it's gonna be the transition from point one to point two. So easy, as you can see, I'm going from the one position to the other. So let's go and control the end position, the X axis, the Y. Let's zoom in a little bit more. You see here that if I go to the right, I see a little bit of mirroring, so I can control this with a few clicks, as you saw. Now we go again, let me disable the coordinates and the path, and here we go. Path one to path two. I will give one more example on these basic movement tools, because the 3D camera tool that I'm gonna drag right now and place it here creates something very unique, especially for drone shots. So what we can do is to set the start position and the end position. Let me show you how we do it. So I'm gonna go here, select the start frame. I'm at the beginning of the frame, and I'm gonna make a little bit of zoom so I can start. And then I will go here, I'm gonna go to endpoint, zoom. Remember that you can control all of these actions from the on-screen buttons as well. And on the position, I can go to the Y. And then you click on view results. Pretty amazing, right? Then we have the camera settings, the film grain, the ISO adjuster. For example, let's take the ISO tool. From here, you can see that I can go to the inspector panel again on the right and make ISO adjustments, and of course, noisiness and the noise blending. And also, if I want to add the film grain tool, I place it on top. I go here on the right in the inspector panel, and I see that I have a lot of different film stock options, like the Fuji, the Kodak, and I can select, let's say, for example, the Tri-X 400 with soft light and opacity you see a very nice and cool film grain. The frame rate, where you can adjust the frame rate to create trail effects. For example, this is how the video looks right now with a normal frame rate of 25 frames per second. I know 25, not 24. We're in Europe, PAL, not NTSC. And let's take this out, how it looks when we reduce the frame rate. This is how it looks with this effect on. Nice. Then we have the shutter speed, the shutter speed echo, and the shutter speed trails, where we can do the trails. See the examples here, how it looks with the balls. Then we have the filter tools. On the filter tools, we have the color filter with the solid color or with three colors, graduated filter, halation diffusion, and let's go and check the halation. We can also have prism filter with different parameters like the parallels that we're gonna use, the starburst effect, and also the streak effect. The streak effect is a very good effect where we can mimic the anamorphic look. Check this out. You see now the lights? We have the lens flares of anamorphic. I'm gonna take the streak effect, place it on top, and you see that I have the anamorphic lens flares already on my footage. I can select the highlight color, the color brightness, how much bright I want to be, the shadow darkness, as you see here, the contrast, and all of the different options. So this is with the streak effect, disabling it. This is without. The starburst effects, we can control the density, the exposure, as you can see here, a lot of stars going on. Then we move on to the focus shifting tool. Here we can rack focus or simple, or we can make it with a mask. And of course, we can do the gradual focus. On the focus shifting tool, let's take a look on the rack focus with a mask. I'm gonna bring this on top of the clip, and then I will go into the inspector panel. And the first thing that I wanna do is to create a mask around my subject. And then we can select the feathering, how much feather we want for the mask. Okay, pretty cool, let's say here. We can set the animation duration, how many seconds we want. Let's take it to 2.5. The focus shift speed, the start blur amount, and the end blur amount, how much blur we want. The gain, the bokeh type, where we can change the bokeh. And let's test it out to see. Simply as that, you create rack focuses. And then we go to the focus tools. Now, on the focus tools, we have some special things going on here, like the custom bokeh tool, the defocus blur, the directional blur. Also, we have the split diopter tool, something very interesting. And we move forward and we go to the lens tools. Now, on the lens tools, we have chromatic aberration. We always want something like that. Curvilinear lens tool, the fisheye correction, especially for footage from action cameras where we have the fisheye and we want to correct it. Or maybe we want to place the vignettes of the fisheye. The lens and dirt and dust, where we can mimic that our lens is getting dirty. RGB distortion. Let's check this out. Let's go back. And the tilt shift tool. Then we have the shake tools. We can have a camera bump, we can have a damaged film, or we can have a random shake. I don't know if you remember, I have created how you create a camera shake, the camera bump in Final Cut Pro without any plugins. This is a procedure that it's easy enough, but even more easy is to have a plugin that with 3-4 clicks you can get the effect right on and get going with your editing. Then we have the viewfinder interfaces, where we can select from DSLR viewfinder, film camera, focus peaking display. This is something that it's new. And keep in mind here that the plugins from Pixel Film Studios get very often upgrades and updates. So you can buy, let's say, a pack for one time, and then you get lifetime upgrades whenever something new comes for this plugin. And then we have the zoom tools. Zoom in, zoom out, zoom in and out, you know, different special things for the zoom in. That I believe there is also a dedicated zoom in plugin for Final Cut Pro from Pixel Film. But as you can see, the FCPX camera have all of the different effects and all of the different capabilities that you can have from a plugin combined into one pack. Pixel Film Studios have a dedicated YouTube channel where they teach Final Cut Pro with a lot of different tutorials. You'll find a link in the description of this video down below for the YouTube channel as well, but remember, that doesn't mean that you will never return back to me. If you have any questions that I can help you, or if you just want to say hi, I'm waiting you in the comment section down below. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and follow me to the other social media like Instagram and Twitter. Thanks so much for watching. I'm Emilio, and I will see you in the next.